Let's look at an example of finding the area of a triangle using Heron's formula. So in this example, we have a triangle, and the lengths of the triangle are 10 meters, 18 meters, and 24 meters. So again, as with all these problems, let me just draw a triangle. Again, I'll do the same thing. I usually draw horizontal bottom side, and then kind of the two other sides slanted upwards to meet in the middle. It doesn't matter where we, doesn't matter what labels, what letters we use to label this triangle, and it doesn't matter where we put the sides. We're not told anything specific about the orientation. So let's just put the 10 meters on the left, the 18 meters on the right, and the 24 meters on the bottom. And just so we have letters to reference our formulas, I would put A, angle A in the bottom left, angle B in the bottom right, and angle C at the top. So that means A, side A is 18, side B is 10, and side C is 24. Okay, so up to this point, again, the area for a triangle that you could use is area equals 1/2 base times height, but we don't know the base and the height. We could also use area is equal to 1/2 AB sine of theta, but that requires one of the angles, which we don't have. So Heron's formula, we first need to compute the semi-perimeter, which is easy to compute. It is half of the sum of the three sides. So 1/2 A plus B plus C. So in this case, the semi-perimeter is going to be 1/2 of 10 plus 18 plus 24. And that sum is going to be 52, so 1/2 of 52. And so our semi-perimeter is going to be 26. Okay, so once we found the semi-perimeter, we can actually go to compute the area. So Heron's formula says that the area is equal to the square root of S times S minus A times S minus B and times S minus C. So we need to plug in S and then compute these three subtractions and then compute the square root. So we have the square root of 26 times 26 minus 18 times 26 minus 10 and then 26 minus 24. And we can simplify that a little bit. We'll have 26 times 8 times 16 and then times 2. And all that's in the square root. And then we can go ahead and multiply all that. So 26 times 8 times 16 times 2. That's a kind of a big number. It's 6,656. So we're taking area is equal to 6,656. And if we actually compute that square root, which we can use our technology to do, it turns out that that area, the square root of 6,656, actually simplifies to 16 times the square root of 26. Or we could approximate that as a decimal. So the area is equal to 81.58. And since we're dealing with measures in meters, this area will be in meters squared. So the area is approximately 81.58 square meters.